Oh yes, you see right. All this is baking in real time with a new add-on called Cell Fluids. It's a completely new approach for fluid simulations based on the new simulation nodes from the Blender Geometry Node system. And it's just crazy. If you installed the plugin, then you can find the Cell Fluids tab in the end panel. And first of all, you have to click on New Fluid. And then you create a new domain of about 10x10 meters. It's quite similar to Manteflow, but keep in mind that you can't change the grid resolution by itself. The resolution is always dependent on the domain size, so you can't change the quality of the simulation. For example, if I crank the domain size up to 20 meters, then the grid resolution is always automatically doubled. And here you can also change the height of the simulation. This won't affect the performance. Only the domain size will affect the performance. And now to the collections. Maybe you know this also from Manteflow, but all objects in the initial fluid collection are just adding one-time fluid at the beginning of the simulation. Then all objects in the inflow collection adding constantly fluid, and all objects in the outflow collection are constantly removing fluid. You can choose here your collection, or you can click on the plus button and create the collections. Here you can also choose a collection for the ground and for the effector, but I will show it to you later. Then let's start by just adding an object. And we put it a bit up. Here we have to put it in the inflow collection. And then as you can see, we already have our fluid. And if I go now to the material preview and play the animation, it already works. And everything is in real time. And I can even move the emitter now and it interacts with the water in real time. Come on, this is so cool. And when I move it to the initial fluid collection, then it adds only fluid one time at the start of the simulation, like this. And to show you how the outflow works, I put the sphere in the outflow collection, then add a new cube for the base water, scale it up so that it's as big as the domain, and then I change the height and put it a bit up so that we have half of the domain filled with water, and then I put it in the initial fluid collection, and I can also hide it here. And if I play the animation now and move the sphere downwards, then as you can see, it absorbs the water. And if you want an effector in the scene, you can choose a collection here or create a new one. And then, for example, we put the sphere in the effector collection and put it a bit up. And then you always have to click on the Setup Effector Modifiers button every time when you put a new object in the Effectors collection so that it works correctly, because the plugin has to put a modifier on each object. So we click on the button and then we can play the animation. And now if we move the object, as you can see, it interacts with the water. One thing I noticed is that it seems to have some limitations on the wave strength. So if I play the animation and then move the object very fast, the waves aren't as high as they should. But yeah, in most cases this will do a good job. Now we come to the extra settings. If you want to make the simulation faster or slower, then you can control it with the timescale. So this is the normal speed, and if you want to have slow motion, for example, then you can just put it down or make it even higher, like this. And you can even change the strength of the displacement, but normally I would leave it to 0.15. And now you can also deactivate the post noise, but normally I wouldn't do it because it adds more details in the water. And here you can also deactivate the extra foam. And if the water don't has to be visible from the side or from the bottom, then you can also deactivate it here. If you want, you can even bake a flow map or change the render settings, but normally I would leave them as they are. With baking a flow map, you convert the current state of the fluid to a static mesh, which is not simulated anymore, but still has the flowing animation. So for example, if I play the animation, and then I want that the fluid should stay at this part, then I can now just click on bake flow map. And then I only have the flowing animation, but the mesh isn't moving anymore. What is good to know, if you want to render it in cycles, then you can get some black parts in the water, and then you would have to go to the render settings and light paths and crank up the transparent bounces. And what is also very cool, that there are different materials included in the plugin. So you just have to go to the materials tab and then choose between the different materials. For example, blood or milk or water dirty. And a last tip, if you want to bake the simulation, then you just have to click on the domain, then go to the physics tab, and here you will find the simulation nodes, and here you can click on bake. And there are also these two test files included to test it a bit. So yeah, what do you think? I guess it's pretty nice. It's crazy for me how fast it is, and I spent so much time the last years for fluid simulations, and here you can just see everything in real time. Of course, it has some limitations, so you can't have single droplets, and splashes or something like that are a bit difficult, but yeah, in many cases it will do a very good job, I think. And if you liked the video, then please leave a thumbs up or a comment below, and then I see you next time.